We have Frozen playing Pyromithra, and we have Solar Beam playing Redbeam.
Period. The really main.
Yeah.
And the Pyromithra. Oh, and Foresight too.
Shenanigans. Oh, the shenanigans already started from the go. And yeah. Frozen. Yeah, she's a player. She used to play Palu. That very. They're very good off with their punish game, right? As you can see, 0 to 80%, and this is going to be one of those situations where if you're Solar Beam, you need to establish like a presence in neutral very quickly, or you're going to get ran all over.
Absolutely. It's just kind of one of those things. I think we've even seen it, you know, a few weeks ago where, you know, Solar Beam just was in this exact position, and they could not get a control over, you know, center stage. But they are going to get that, you know, up smash on that platform right there. And I aren't No, the F smash is going to take it, but what I was going to say is that, you know, really does do really well, you know, with catching a lot of, you know, stuff that people try to do whenever they're landing. Has a very good nair, has a very good F smash, and a lot of those times,
yeah,
if you're ever poorly misbasing anything on really, you will get up smashed and or nair to the face, and you will die, and that is going to be two stocks apiece for both of these players, you know. Very even right now, but also it's just very hard for, you know, Solar Beam to actually do anything, and it's very understandable when you're playing a character like Ridley who has, you know, a bad disadvantage like, you know, most heavies do.
Yeah, and yeah, I'm sorry, I was just watching, he was just getting smoked, like, and he hasn't been able to play the game so far, like, you know, good board or off the ledge, but it's one of those things where it's like, usually Ridley does pretty decent against sword characters, right? Because you can't land on Ridley. A lot of sword characters like to jump at you. But Mithra is so fast and she's on top of you that it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if she's a sword character if you cannot react or get away from her. And it's just, you know, and I'm liking how Frozen's switching back to Mithra and not tunnel visioning on Pyro, because sometimes they tunnel, you know, these Pyromithra players tunnel vision on Pyro and lose the plot, and then they lose the game because they were fishing too much. But reestablishing neutral with Mithra, punishing a Pyro, and that's the name of the game.
Absolutely. That's just what it's looking like right now. And the thing about both these characters is that they have really, you know, they're a really good character. They have a lot of really nice buttons. And just looking at these buttons right here, just going out so well for Frozen, already having them at 52%. And if you're not careful, this could spell a really bad time for, you know, Solar Beam.
Yeah. Yeah, but Solar Beam's sticking to it. The one thing that Solar Beam has been doing well is punishing at the ledge. That was a crazy punish. I feel like when Solar Beam has put Frozen on the ledge, they've been doing a very good job at, you know, holding that lead. But the thing is, they haven't been in that position too many times. And this is his chance right here. He didn't get the two-frame forward tilt. And that's the thing. When Mithra is recovering that, that's like the one thing you want. You want her to recover like that, because that recovery is like extremely bad.
It is more than just bad. It's just one of the worst things about this character. However, you know, that command grab is going to take that stock, and we have Solar Beam at a huge deficit, but they are heavy, so they can survive a lot longer. And you know, the thing about Pyra is that Pyra, their buttons are so good, but also so, like, irritating, because they have a lot of, I feel like they have a lot of priority, especially since, you know, they're very big, and they're just super strong, so not only that, but it just could spell a very bad time. But it's looking like a little bit of a bad time if Frozen can't actually get a hold of, you know, this stage right now, because they can die off of this ledge trap right here and not gonna get off the anything. But, you know, they are putting Solar Beam back into the corner, and they're just trying to throw anything that will kill Solar Beam right now. And that F smash
actually hit the ledge. I didn't think that was gonna reach. Yeah, I was gonna say don't side me, because you will lose your stuff. And this is the thing, right? Frozen was on Pyra, and immediately Solar Beam started running the neutral. And then switched to Mithra, and then, like,
Wow.
Yeah, she's very wary. She's not trying to land on top of Ridley right now. If you try to land on Ridley now, you will lose your stock. Like, that's a stock loss if you try to land on Ridley right now.
Absolutely. I really feel like, you know, they've just been in the corner this whole time, and that jab is going to take it.
Way that took the stock. That was disgusting.
That job is so good. Hello.
There's no way. I know that job is good. That was disgusting.
Absolutely. That job is amazing. Literally, like, if I didn't hate Aegis, I would probably play them.
Yeah.
This character is so good.
Wow. 1, 2, 3, gentlemen. Okay, yeah. But that was Yeah, good stuff by Frozen closing it out, but like Solar Beam was on it, and that's what I'm talking about, right? Like, Ridley is a character, right? They are quote-unquote bad because their disadvantage is, like, can be pretty bad. They're big body. Not really a super heavy, even though they have a size of a super heavy, right? But the thing about them is, like, they can punish you pretty hard for being above them in Solar and being at the ledge. They have very good ledge trapping, right? And Solar Beam really showed that, like, throughout the game that they can hold that ledge pressure and hold that punish game while they're on top of them. It took out the last stock, last hit, and we're going to Battlefield, and this is going to be a stage where they can pretty much cover almost all these angles comfortably with their range.
Absolutely, and I really think that they need to be able to, you know, hold that ledge trapping in a lot more situations, because they were doing really well, but it just got to a point where they weren't really considering that, you know, at this point they can really take the stock. You know, they went for that F smash, and although it didn't work out, like, they just could have, you know, maybe positioned themselves a little bit better so that they actually, you know, could take that stock. But we have to get into this next game. We have to talk about this game, and we're already seeing, you know, a normal point at this, you know, time and moment where we have Solar Beam at 123% and climbing, and this could honestly be death. You know, not now at least.
And I feel like, honestly, this is the most we've been seeing out of Pyro, because almost exclusively, Frozen gets hit once or twice as Pyro and just immediately switches to Mithra. Like, okay, like that's good, I'm done. Right? And right now, it seems like you're doing a very good job at holding this lead with Pyro, not switching to Mithra yet, so it's a good sign on Frozen's end.
Absolutely.
Ooh. Yeah, and this, again, that's the switch, right? And yeah, and Solar Beam just applying pressure. That was a really good up smash to check that jump in. And yeah, that fireball. And what are we talking about? The ledge pressure? Immediately put them at the ledge and immediately took the stock.
Hello. That's crazy. That's wild. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Okay, yeah, Solar Beam's doing some stuff.
I don't know. They're trying to style. They trying to style. Hello. But, you know, you try to style, and then now you're offstage and already at 62%. And that was just a really good, you know, gimp, like, from Solar Beam taking that stock. But this is just a lot of the game. They have to find some way to get back to center stage so they can hold this lead as much as they need to.
You know, I feel like the story of this set has been getting the neutral ran by Mithra. And once Pyro comes in, the game kind of starts for Ridley a little bit, funny enough. And you see immediately Solar Beam is able to get out the corner, start moving around. And this is going to be Solar Beam's part. Whenever they get the Pyro switch, that's when they need to figure out how they want to play this neutral.
That was a very nice mix-up. They've been trying to read a lot of these options with F smash, and it just hasn't been working out too well. I feel like they're trying to read, you know, a roll in and whatnot, but it just hasn't been, you know, the right kind of read and whatnot.
Yeah, and Frozen just go step back and throw about that forward smash, and Solar Beam's just not moving. Right, just staying in the corner, because they're shook. And I feel like I'm seeing a command grab in the near future from Solar Beam. If Frozen keeps shielding like that.
We could definitely see that be a possibility. And the foresight into F smash, that's so crazy. That was actually really amazing from Frozen. Yeah. And that F tilt gonna take it. They were trying to stay on that ledge. I don't know.
Yeah, you definitely deserve that. Like, doing that twice with Ridley. Oh, waiting for the air dodge, not getting the grab too slow. And Frozen's on the punish. A nice wait, trying to get that nair through shield as Ridley was hurtling on platform. And man, like, that's like, 0-60?
Mm-hmm. What you thought this was? And that nair too, that nair is so good coming down sometimes. It just catches a lot of people, and it can actually even kill sometimes. And we're just getting put into the same position we've seen time and time again. We need to see, you know, just hopefully something different where we can see maybe, you know, Solar Beam actually take the stock.
Yeah, I mean this is pretty much like their winner's life right now. Trying to take the stock, and yeah, waiting at the ledge, not wanting to get hit by Pyro. And now this is it. This is where they play the game now, right? And they have stage position right now, and this is it. Like, this is going to be the make or break it point right now. You can't let Frozen regain neutral and immediately get foresighted.
And that's going to kill.
That feels terrible. Imagine doing all that, regaining neutral, and then get foresighted into lose a stage advantage into I lost my stock, stupid. Like,
I'm going to be completely honest. Miss Frozen, she's been on point with all of these foresights. I've never seen a lot of, like, you know, Aegis players who are on site, like, on, like, point with their foresight, and it's just, like, super amazing to see. Mm-hmm. She's definitely been, you know, on it with that, and I think that's kind of just, like, one of the things that is kind of, like, an indication of how well she gets accustomed to a lot of, you know, these situations in neutral. She understands when, you know, Solar Beam is going to throw a lot of these options, and whenever she's just, like, okay, I'm ready to go in, she goes in, foresights, and then punishes, you know, Solar Beam for actually whatever, you know, they want to do. And, like, and it's just one of those things. She didn't even need to do it that often. I think it was probably 2 or 3 times that she actually did it that entire set. And to be able to do that and actually, you know, make it to a point where you actually killed, that was just super amazing. I definitely love that play from Frozen. Amazing. Beautiful.
Yeah.